main sails!
Let's catch some wind!
Every last scrap of duck on the wind!
I know she's a good sailor! I think we've lost them, sir.
Reef in, all tops!
Haul down and crew up! Curl those men!
Why, look! It's the bastard son of the late William Kidd. Still a mere boy, and yet, 10 times the demon his father was.
Thank you, Mother.
Fancy seeing you here, Kenway. Still looking sleek and mean. Did you steal that costume from a dandy in Havana?
No, sir. I found this on a corpse. One that was walking about and talking shite to my face only moments before. So, what's this I hear about a planned raid on a plantation? Not keeping secrets from me, are you?
Not very well. Every day, schooners packed with sugar sail past, coming from plantations nearby. Most times they stop here, sell off a few crates. There's one man visiting today that'd earn you a fine profit. So if you'd like to rob his plantation, I'll point him out.
I would. Is it a Mr. Beckford that owns this plantation?
That's the man. He owns dozens round these islands, and he's bloody rich.
Just the sort I like to see robbed.
His agent is around here somewhere. Find and follow him, and he'll lead you straight to your prize.
trade of prices Mr. Beckford knows are fair, and with a quality he knows is sound.
If it's hearty molasses and raw cake, that's a given.
It gladdens me to hear your saying so. Despite the waywardness of your enterprise here, I understand that you are men of discernment. Burford, Manning, to me. We've done with this place.
Aye, sir. What's our course?
We'll return to the plantation and there take stock of our inventory. It was a good harvest this year.
You might not talk so loud, sir. This isn't anything like a friendly port, Ken.
Nonsense, man. I had a delightful conversation with that just now. We came to quite an understanding.
As you say, sir.
All up and unfurl, boys. We're going home.
You have the look of a man crafting a bold idea. A look I've seen before.
You mark well, Adam. I've just overheard one of the Beckford's men talking grandly about his plantation and all the cargo he's keeping there, and it gave me the idea that I might take these goods off him and sell them off for a better price than he'd ever ask.
Ah, a man of vision. I like this idea.
Trouble afoot.
I see them.
This man's working for Peter Beckford's people. Do you know them? The Beckfords and their sugar empire.
Aye. The Beckfords and the Draxes. I never worked their plantations, but I knew their names from hearing other men curse them.
But you worked a plantation, no?
A modest one, aye. As a striker in the boiling house.
Boiling house? Was it water they boiled, or something else?
Cane juices. It's a hard process making sugar. Dangerous, too. Must be why it fetches such a dear price.
What's it like? Toiling on a plantation day and night.
Well, with the cane sugar cut and harvested, it's run between two metal rollers and crush the juice from the plant. After collecting the juice, It was time to boil away the waters from the sugar. This we did in Tatches with the copper. Let me tell you, brother, boiling sugar is near the hottest thing on earth. Just a touch on the skin will stick like birdlime and burn on, leaving a terrible scar.
Jesus.
Sir, to the starboard! Survivor here, sir!
Foul weather there, Captain!
It's a risk to anchor too close. The soldiers roving the plantation will catch us for sure.
Drop here then and sneak ashore. We'll look after the jackal.
Disarray.
Bit of a do, sir, that's all. It's Wilmington's birthday.
And you saw fit to get pickled on duty?
Don't bother, sir. We've everything sorted.
We'll soon see, won't we? For you must double the watch this evening.
Double, sir? Whatever for?
I believe I was followed here, young man. By pirates, if my eyes are deceived. Though the ship was uncommonly large for such rascals. Certainly wasn't slavers, though. Not a ship that size. In any case, double the watch. And keep your damned eyes wide for anything suspicious. You up there! Look alive, man! You've a job to do!
Apologies, sir. I'll keep my eyes peeled.
What the hell is going on here today? How do you suppose you'll be able to ring that alarm if you're pissed drunk and barely able to stand? I'd like to speak to the man in charge here. I require entrance to the warehouse. Which of you dogs has the key to the warehouse, huh? Is there no one sober here? Fetch me the warehouse key, if you please.
Stand still.
That's permitted.
Pirate activity.
You there, stop!
Bloody pirates! My phone's almost out, and there's a new girl at Miss Hannah's. I'd love to leave my modi work on.
Into the wind!
Loose tops and royals!
Water!
Here's to our pirate republic, lads. We're prosperous, and free, and out of the reach of kings, clergy, and debt collectors.
Near 500 men now pledge their allegiance to the Brethren of the Coast in Nassau. Not a bad number.
True. Yet we lack sturdy defenses. If the king were to attack the town, he'd trample us.
Then let us find the observatory. If it does what these Templars claim, we'll be unbeatable.
Not that twaddle again, can we? It's a story for schoolboys. I mean, proper defenses. Steal a galleon, shift all the guns to one side. Would make a nice ornament for one of our harbors.
It will not be easy to steal a full Spanish galleon. Have you one in mind?
I do, sir. And I'll show you. She's a fussock, she is. Fat and slow.
Jackdaw handles nice. Pinched her from the Spanish, was it?
Aye. In the midst of a hurricane.
Just before the treasure fleet was smashed against the shore.
Was the haul aboard as rich as men are saying?
1,000 times that. I reckon £1,000,000 worth of reals was sunk that day.
Devil love a hurricane. Might have a dive there one day. See what we can rummage up.
Diving them wrecks would be a nice change of pace for us. No need for violent actions against merchants and such.
Well, that's some soft talk coming from a pirate. And as it happens, I mostly agree. We'll save the clashing of cutlasses for the military. And them that get in our way. Easy as she goes. No telling what you may find out here.
Like staring through a waterfall.
Don't soil your breeches, lads. I got this.
Cannot be far now. That ship's a monster. Look at the size of her.
Aye. And we'd not last long face to face with her. Hear that, Kenway? Keep your distance. We'll strike when fortune favors her.
The cover of darkness, most likely.
Aye, it may come to that.
Check those royals!
Douse all but me!
Ease the spanker! Hold down!
Crowd it all on!
Loose all! Party like!
Douse the gallants and royals!
Four!
As much sail as you can!
Stunsels! Let's ride the squall!
Reef the topsails and gallant! Royals and tops! More sail! All sail!
Loose topsails, gallants and royals!
Trim the yards off the wind! Loose all, let's move!
We ride the wind, we're all sitting...
Starboard! Human flops him in broad, Captain. Seems to be survived.
Stunsails in! Clew up!
Charles Fane. He's as reckless as they come.
An old friend of yours?
Not a man I'd call a friend. But we've been doing this kind of work for so long, I can't help but respect him.
Let's get moving! Fire!
sailing for that island.
I know the place. Natural stronghold used by a French captain named Ducasse.
Julian Ducasse, the Templar.
Name's right. Didn't know he had a title.
I know the man. And if he sees my ship, he'll know it from his time in Havana, meaning he may wonder at who's sailing her now. I can't risk that.
And I don't want to lose that galleon. Let's think on't. Maybe wait till it's dark before hopping aboard.
Captain's trick.
Loose and trim too. Crowd on every inch of sail.
Clues down. Man your sheets.
You young sailormen, listen to me. I'll sing you a song of the fish in the sea. And it's windy weather, boys, stormy weather, boys, when the wind blows. We're all together, boys, blow ye winds westerly, blow ye winds, ho! Jolly sou'wester, boys, steady she goes. Up jumps the eel with a slippery tail, climbs up aloft and reefs the topsail. And it's windy weather, boys, stormy weather, boys, when the wind blows, we're all together, boys, blow ye wind westerly, blow ye wind blow. Jolly sou'wester, boys, steady she goes. And then up jumps the shark with his 9 rows of teeth, saying, you eat the dough, boys, and I'll eat the meat. And it's windy weather, boys, stormy weather.
Gentlemen, as is custom among our kind, we do not plunge headlong into folly on the orders of a single madman, but act according to our own collective madness. The object of our attention is a square-rigged galleon, and we want her for the advantage she'll bring Nassau. So I'll put it to the vote. All those in favor of storming this cove and taking this ship, stomp and shout aye!
Aye!
Those who oppose, whimper nay!
Never was the King's Council so unified.
que no miras tú?
¡Alto!
¡Quiero matar más fácilmente!
¡Ya te tenemos, gusano!
Double time!
Bravely, lads! See that the cargo is secure!
Remember the gift you gave me? Well, it answers just fine.
Fist of putain! As bold as a musket ball, and still half as sharp!
I'm sorry about this, mate, but I can't risk you telling your Templar friends about me still kicking around.
I pity you, Boukenier. After all you have seen, after all we showed you of our order, still you embrace the life of an ignorant and aimless rogue!
What's this?
Is petty larceny the extent of your ambition? Have you no mind to comprehend the scope of ours? All the empires on Earth, abolished, a free and open world, without parasites like you! Que l'enfer que tu trouveras soit le fruit de ton insouciance.
Cove is ours!
I just saw you were logging out, so I thought I'd stop by and give you something. A little welcome gift. We give awards to our top-notch employees for doing quality work. And they're nice to have, since there's no official bonus scheme here. I already have about 11 or so. Oh. Bonjour. Of course. I'll pass it on. Well, looks like Olivier wants to meet with you. It's exciting. Follow me. It's on the top floor, so it's not hard to find. But the rest of this building can be confusing to first-timers, so we had the tools team whip up a great map application. Check your communicator. I added a waypoint to Olivier's office. Should be easy to find. Olivier's a nice guy. He won't bite.
Calibrating your animus? I'm sort of the, Scotty of this Abstergo Enterprise. In charge of all the tech stuff. Do you have a minute? Oh, damn it. The tracker says you're on your way to Olivier's office. All right. I'll ping you when you're done. I have a favor to ask.
Bonjour. Go right in. He's waiting for you.
Well, unless you are specifically ordering me to abandon it, I won't jeopardize our flagship project. Edward Kenway is the... But this is how Hollywood got its start, right? With pirate movies. Douglas Fairbanks, Errol Flynn, and now we have access to the real deal. Wait. Exactly. We'll talk about all that together at the shareholders' event. Right. Looking forward to seeing you too. Take care, Letizia. Salut! Hi! Thanks for coming in. I know you're busy. So, I reviewed some of your data. Pretty raw stuff. Obviously, we need to scrub off some of the dirt to make it family-friendly. Maybe give Edward a voice like James Bond or something. More of a ladies' man. A beautiful city, no? So, the main reason I asked you here concerns something called the observatory. It's been mentioned a few times in the footage you found. I'd like to encourage you to focus on locating this specific set of memories as soon as possible. If it were up to me, on s'en acquérisse. I wouldn't bother. But some bigwigs at Abstergo Industries have been hounding me for days. So, follow whatever leads you find, and hopefully we can... Oh, incoming call. I have to take this. We'll keep in touch. Bonne journée. Alan, bonjour. Oui, 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 tout va bien. Naturellement. Bon, d'accord. Pourquoi?
Hi, John from IT again. You got a second? Good. I'm adding a waypoint to your map. So, a colleague of yours left for vacation this morning and forgot to send a video file she promised me. Since I hate just about everyone else on your floor, I was hoping you could help me. Could you transfer the file from her computer and deliver it to the courier when she comes? It'll be easy. You just wander over to their animus, log in, and transfer the file. Easy. And please be snappy before I find a reason to hate you, too. A locked door. Not a problem. That's the advantage of me having level 1 security clearance. Now, you do, too. Don't abuse it. Log on, and I'll walk you through this. Now, you need to bypass the core to find the data inside. Once you reach it, your communicator will download it automatically. You need to find your way around the core to reach the data inside. You cracked it. Good. The file should be downloading. I set up a database for any data you find. Just look for the My File section in your communicator, and you'll be redirected right away. Everything you download will be found in there. Protected by a firewall, of course.
December 23rd, 2012. Sample Recovery Unit Team Lead Fisher Case reporting on Subject 17, Desmond Miles. The subject was deceased and unattended. Time of death was placed around 00 hours and 7 minutes, with conditions favorable for DNA sample recovery. We had some initial concerns about interference in the vault, but given the skill and talent of this team, we were able to capture useful data. I personally retrieved the subject's backpack and extracted a number of objects of interest to undergo detailed analysis. The subject displayed burns to the right hand, severe enough to fuse the bones, indicating some kind of spontaneous, intense burn trauma. Honestly, we've never seen anything like it before. Head, neck, and torso remained in good condition. I hand-selected recovery agents to retrieve fluid samples, blood and saliva. We then commenced material extraction and were able to preserve several exemplary samples. Data analysis and sequencing is already underway, and I'm told proceeding with exceptional ease thanks to the cloud database and the work of Abstergo Sample Recovery Unit 3. The legacy of Subject 17 will continue uninhibited as Sample 17.
I'd hope. Now zip on down to the lobby. Come on. See? That file you acquired? I wouldn't recommend watching it. I mean, ooh, you could, but it's unpleasant. So once you hand it off, just pretend this never happened, okay? Otherwise, you'll just go to bed feeling sad. Anyway, the courier should be waiting downstairs. She's been here a while. I suppose it goes without saying, just because you now know how to hack all your colleagues' computers, it doesn't mean you should. I mean, not every day, right? No, seriously, though, that's illegal, so don't be a dick.
I am not sure I can keep this up, you know? This job is well below my skill level.
Yeah, well, your coffee is shit. You could use some practice.
What? No, no, no. I followed that recipe to the letter. Oh, look who's here. So you didn't forget, after all. You're just incredibly rude. And made poor Rebecca here wait for nearly 30 minutes.
You limey. Be nice. Sorry about him. He's high on his own supply. So, how should we do this? Data transfer? Great. That should do it. We'll email you the receipt. Till next time. Take care, Sean.
Bye-bye. Yes, bye. And don't expect any more free coffee. Arrogant. She's great, isn't she?
Hey, I just got word the courier has come and gone. Wonderful, you're a miracle. No, that's an exaggeration. You're not a miracle. You're an employee, doing a job. But thanks for helping out. Anyway, thanks. Have fun pirating.
Assistance au niveau 2, projet échantillon 17. Support to the second floor, sample 17 project.
Oi. Where you going, the market?
No, I... My parents have asked me to come live with them, and I'd like to.
Oh, what do you mean, live with them? You live here with me.
I'm sorry, Edward, but my father is right. You had a decent wage when you worked the farm. Why can you not be satisfied with that? With me?
Decent wage? That job was near as, damn it, to robbery. You want to be married to a peasant the whole of your life?
All right, Edward. All right.
You leave now, Caroline. You'll never know what's coming to us. Caroline! Caroline!
Kid.
Wake up, Kenway.
What's that about?
He left this morning with the galleon. As faith, we'll discover a good use for this old cove ourselves.
Aye, we'll make something of it in time. We could keep a fleet here if we like. And with a bit of fixing up, it'd be a decent place to call home. Might even convince my wife to come one day.
You're married, are you?
In God's eyes, I am. She left me some time ago.
Even so, keep that fact hid away. Most of these pirates don't respect a man with higher commitments than rum and plunder.
Upon mine honor, let me know if you find anything.